A warm welcome to all of you.
If you come to IIM Bangalore, we will of course have all these heavy-duty professors with PhDs from the world-class universities, from the IIMs, and so on. And they will push you hard and make you work very hard. But the learning that will take place will be, a lot of it will be from your conversations with each other. And recognizing that, we have made a small change in the program this year, and that is instead of having you coming on Friday mornings and then going back to work and coming on Saturday, we're going to ask you to come on Friday evenings so you can stay the night and then be with us Saturday. And as you can see, the only difference there is that you're going to be with us on Friday evenings. And of course, we're going to make you work 12 hours in the night on a night shift. Even if we tried, you wouldn't succeed. We'll only make you work a few hours on Friday evening, and then you will interact with your colleagues who, whether you like it or not, will teach you stuff. And later on, we'll ask you 10 years later whether what you learnt from Abhoy was that much more valuable than what you learnt from yourselves.
I'm really glad that you could make time on a Sunday morning to come here and sort of get to know more about the program that we offer. PGPEM, which is the one that we are going to talk about today, is again targeting the same group of people. People who have gone up the ladder based on their functional skills, and now they want to get into more general managerial roles. The only difference between the two is, while the EPGP requires one to quit their job and come here and do a full-time program, the PGPM is targeted at people in a similar profile, but who, for a variety of reasons, either they're enjoying their job or they don't want to quit, they cannot quit, they should be able to engage with us and get that knowledge even as they work. There are benefits to that, but our target is to people who are reasonably happy with their work, their industry, they just want to grow up into managerial roles into that segment. Okay. Now, some details. It's designed for mid-career senior managers from across industries. Now, I'm highlighting across industries because part of the open house process is to make people know that while in its original form, this program was targeted largely to IT and software industry, today we are open to everyone. And as I'll tell you later, we have been prepared to, in the selection process, favor people from outside the software and IT industry. And we will tell to that. And we'll talk about that, why we need to do that, why diversity in the class is important, both from a perspective of society and also from a perspective of learning in the class. So it's targeted at people who want to continue working even as they upgrade their skills. It's a 22-month program. One has tried to schedule it such that your work disruption is the least. So 22 months is about the best we could do in terms of scheduling, such that you get enough credits that allows us to give you a diploma, and yet sort of in your career, you have to kind of plan for a short period. The residential, this was never there. And in fact, ever since we announced that we are going to have a residential program for next year, the people who are already in the program are putting pressure on us that, why can you give it to the new batch and why not to us? And so I just assured them that we'll work, given the infrastructure availability, we'll try to make them available to them. So this seems to be something that will allow us, the residential portion will allow us to not only allow you to interact amongst each other and learn from each other, but also an opportunity for us to have some keynote speakers coming in pre-dinner. It will also allow us to help you do a lot of social activities or whatever, learning activities outside the classroom. So we haven't had it yet, but given the experiences of some other institutions, we believe that the learning experience will be great. Credit requirements are the same as the EPGP. As I said, These two programs are both targeted at mid-career executives. One requires you to quit the work, the other other allows you to continue. Quarters, this is getting into details. Your sessions are going to be organized by 10 quarters as a stretch, and the 11th week you'll have a exam. Depending on when the festivals fall, etc., etc., you might have a break between terms, you might not have a break between terms, okay. 4 quarters of core courses, 4 quarters of electives, classes on Friday afternoons and Saturdays, although there may be greater flexibility during elective. Now, idea is you are allowed to do electives. There is going to be some dedicated electives to your program, but since you all will be part of a diploma granting program, and your schedule allows you to come on a weekday and do some elective that you want to do on a day which is Monday or Tuesday, which is not normally scheduled for you, if there is capacity, we will allow you to do it, okay. So, the Friday afternoon and Saturday applies in a very strict format only for the core program. For the elective program, there's more flexibility, okay. Of course, you will get two electives with others. Exchange opportunities. Now, exchange opportunities that IMB has are not at program level, they are at institutional level. So there are relationships, MOUs that IMB has signed with other partners, and people from the PGPM are eligible for them, the ways of allocating them, etc., etc. When we have designed our programs, we have taken good care to understand what the outside world needs, what we need to know about the outside world, and all our programs, PGPM being one of them, all our programs are trying to identify some space in the outside world that is relevant to IMB and trying to engage with
people in your situation. Sometimes think about is an MBA necessary? You can obviously have a great career without an MBA, and there are individuals who've done that. You can make billions of dollars being an entrepreneur without having finished undergraduate. I mean, look at Bill Gates and Steve Jobs and others. You will find that almost any activity on the that involves human livelihood, whether it's a small entrepreneur, whether you're running an NGO, whether you're in government, has something to do with organizing people, organizing resources, managing them effectively and efficiently. And all of that activity, value addition in society, falls under the ambit of a management education.
PGPEM has been a real engine of transition for me. And in the last 6 months, which have been very eventful, I've gone through 6 subjects, 8 textbooks. I have had the experience of working with some great minds from the industry who are my classmates now. I've had the absolute pleasure of learning from and interacting with some of the best faculty that one can approach.
We also have immersion programs. I don't want to get into the details. There are some of these discussions sort of happening, which country, where, that will only we'll reveal to you as we go along, but there are definitely efforts to have you have some international exposure by the time you graduate.
Teaching folks like you was really very interesting because you brought your own experience. And also for the students, you could take your learning from the classroom and take it back to your workplace right away. You didn't have to wait for 2 years or 1 year. So you could actually, when somebody is talking about an issue, you could relate to it right away.
Talking about my class, it's a great mix of students, people from a variety of job backgrounds, having different responsibilities in their organizations, coming with varied experiences, different number of work experience, which adds to the discussion that we have in the class. And professors always engage us in that manner. Learning through those discussions is actually a big advantage that our program has, because people bring experience into the class.
So you have to make a commitment to yourself that yes, I have sort of done enough to create that balance for me to devote attention to this program. Because the standards are high, we will drive you, we will force you. Because we are giving a diploma, my colleagues will do what they have to do. And if you have not had that inner conversation with yourself and convince yourself that I'm going to be able to devote the time to this program, you will get into trouble. So I would say spouse, employer, but have that conversation with yourself that you have it in you to devote the time to do this program.
Talking specifically about the course, it is a well-designed program, addresses specific needs, and it gives you a perspective of management nuances. That precisely what was what I was looking for from a program. Our faculty are amongst the best in the discipline. They facilitate learning through discussion in the class. They bring in classroom discussion in a very beautiful way. They have a brilliant perspective on various subjects that they cover, and they are able to share it in a very effective manner with us.
Our program, it not only has a strong core program which will give you general management inputs, it also has electives. So you can actually graduate and try to get into marketing roles, etc. Okay?
Faculty expect a lot of effort from us. They expect great quality from us, and they enable us to deliver that. We have some of the best facilities and resources, well-equipped classrooms, great library, well-stacked library, and a way to interact with one another through by using these facilities, and also a great recreational facility on campus.
I never knew economics. I really wish if I knew economics was such a beautiful subject, I think I would have done my BA. Thanks to the Institute, I learned economics at its very fundamentals. I think in an Indian educational system, we are not taught many things early in our life. You know, you become a doctor, you become an engineer. But I think if you receive the program very openly, you will start enjoying.
I think Uma mentioned a bit about IMB as a brand and which the way it helps you. I can tell you from my entrepreneurship journey that I just need to say I use my IIM email ID to ask for meetings, and I get my meetings immediately. Whenever I use my company ID and ask, there is quite a little, I mean the percentage is very low, but I try to use my IIM alumni ID and send a meeting request or a request for some discussion. It usually opens up and then I get a meeting very easily.
After I graduated around 2006-2007, GE was going through a huge change, and the change was, like all of you seen this before, how do you build products for emerging markets, right? And that was the time when I had domain experience in anesthesia machines. I was called in to say, okay, your group is going to figure out how you will build something for the India market. And we did that for 2 years. You know, we launched our first product. We were not so successful. We launched our second one. And today I lead the business for anesthesia for all of emerging markets. Now, when I go along the way and I just reflect on the 7 years where I couldn't have done this without continuously picking things along the way. It wasn't just what I was taught in class here, but a lot of the concepts resonated for me to apply. And a couple of examples I will give you. We were taught balance scorecards in our course. And at that time, it just sounded so theoretical to me. I was like, okay, so there are all these metrics and you're going to measure yourself against them. How does that really work? But when you start over time to apply them and you go back and take the time to really reread, really relearn what you had done, I think it becomes so much more apt to what you're doing in your given situation. So, you know, don't hesitate to use your resources within your organization to continue your learning journey. Right? And for instance, while we were on that journey, we also actually tied up with various local institutions because we were looking for talent, people who would do things fast and, you know, very, very quick engineering prototypes. So we tied up with IIT Chennai to do things like that. So every time I go there, I feel I learn a completely, you know, just 2 days over there, I feel I just come back with so much more learning. So there is that, that's continuous. No matter whether it's IIM, it's IIT, you know, it's academic touch, however you do it, don't give up on it. And it's up to you. Hopefully, it will give you the maturity to pursue those opportunities.
Admission, a bachelor's degree from a recognized university in any discipline. Minimum requirements is 3 years work experience and after graduation.
I've had a great time here at PGPEM. It's been a learning, fulfilling experience for me. PGPM, in my view, is a comprehensive management program which will help you pursue your goals for a career path to move into higher management roles.
I didn't do my course once. I actually ended up doing it twice because my wife also did the course. So it was almost like a 4-5 year PGSEM for me. Though I didn't study with her, but actually I went through the same rigor because she was doing it and I had to listen to all what was going on.
I wish you good luck. with your applications, and I would encourage you to apply for this this course.
I have felt in my career this is totally worth it, and I hope that you will too. So we look forward to you being with us, and I think I'll stop now and chat with you later. Please send me an email anytime you want. We can meet if you want. Okay. I'm very accessible. I enjoy these interactions. So welcome again.